Thank you. jumps and waves.
In our circus is the traditional star of the clarinet section, if only in their own minds, the B-flat soprano clarinet. Wally, who is the tightrope walker, he will demonstrate that after the concert, will demonstrate a tradition known as klezmer. He will also demonstrate that just because you're playing in a minor key doesn't mean that it has to be sad.
Thank you.
Next up are the alto and the tenor sections of our clarinet choir. We have the E-flat alto clarinet and the basset horn pitched in F. Now, these sections in a vocal choir don't often get the melody, and the same, sadly, is true in the clarinet choir. But now this is their chance to shine with a little excerpt from Peter and the Wolf by Prokofiev. And now we come to the lions of our somewhat strained circus metaphor, the bass clarinets. Now, like the lions in the circus, the bass clarinets like to vie for territory, and sometimes they have to fight a bit. Gentlemen. I'm not sure that we have a winner. So, you know what we can do? So, in the spirit of the musical Hamilton, let's assume we're in New York City for a little while, and there's a boat that goes to Weehawken. So, in Hamilton, they're going to row across to fight the duel between Hamilton and Aaron Burr. They're going to go to New Jersey, where everything is legal. So, so let's see who will take the first shot. Ken, take the first shot. And we have a winner! All right. And I think, finally, we have the little person of the clarinet choir, the E-flat sopranino clarinet, working with another instrument in harmonious counterpoint. Now, the exciting thing about the B-flat contrabass clarinet is they were voted most likely in their high school class to be turned into kitchen plumbing. So, here they are. We have one more surprise that, as we've introduced our wonderful percussionist, James Abate, before, who is not a clarinet player, but he does play enough to teach 4th, 5th, and 6th graders, so which is why we let him, why we hired him for the gig. Mr. Abate. All right, and as Kathy mentioned, the final movement is of the clarinet circus is based on the music and takes some of the themes from Charles Ives. Now, this is going to be a surprise, and part of what Ives was after. Now, he was a committed New Englander, and he believed in the ultimate democracy of the New England town meeting. And he incorporated this idea of everybody giving their opinions all at once. Sometimes it was organized, more often than not, it was not. So you're going to hear some familiar themes from Ives, but very often we're sort of organized, but other times it's the New England town meeting or any other committees that you may have been part of at some point, where everyone's going to be vying for attention. This is the grand finale of our circus section of our concert.
Thank you.